Let's talk a little sports. Draymond Green opted out his contract a few days ago, making him a free agent. But the big key to that is the Warriors traded Jordan Poole for Chris Paul. Now, obviously Steve Kerr has been more vocal after the season that the assault that Draymond Green did to his teammate by punching the man in the face unprovoked because he didn't punch him, fractured the team. I'm sure the veterans sided with Draymond Green's position, and young guys who were the reason they won a championship, the last one, sided with Brother Poole. So obviously they gave him a contract right after that. He didn't play up to the same level that he played with the other guys the year before. So they decided to go in a different direction. The problem with this whole scenario is Chris Paul is never healthy in the playoffs. He is a great mind when it comes to coaching young guys and getting players in position to be successful. But when you need him in the playoffs, the last few playoffs, he's been hurt. And we can go all the way back to Houston. You pick the team. The Suns, you pick the team, he's not been able to last that long. Now, the league has changed. Obviously, you have more player management situations where you can play every other game. You look at Kawhi Leonard, you look at Paul George, you look at a lot of guys are taking more days off to rest their injuries or just don't want to play back-to-back. Certain situations where you can kind of prolong your season. So we'll see if that helps Chris Paul. The problem is the Warriors are still older. The Warriors have a lot of miles on them. They went deep in the playoffs for many, many years. That's Curry, Klay, Draymond, Chris Paul, and his great teams. He went deep in the playoffs for many, many years. So having that as your front and then relying on the young guys when you got rid of one of the biggest young guys, offensively anyway, Jordan Poole, I think is a mistake. But I think the Warriors really want to keep the nucleus together. They're not really trying to go young just yet. I think they still want the Curry, Draymond, Klay, Steve Kerr show to continue, which is whatever. But I think if you would have got rid of Draymond, I think he will re-sign. But if you say we don't want Draymond and we're going to try to keep going younger, they might can eke out one more championship. I think the West is going to be hard the next couple of years. Denver can keep those guys together. All those guys are under contract at least one more year. Brown is the only one that opted out. I think he'll be able to come back, but even if he don't, they got so many defenders and guys off the bench that can take his role. Even though his role was very important to the Denver Nuggets' success and championship, it's not something they can lose and just never get back. They can just next man up it, and they'll be fine. But I think Denver will be there next year. I think the Suns, given the whole year with a new coach and with Booker and Durant, will be there. They got to get some guy on the bench, but I think obviously the Lakers will be there. You know, I think a lot of teams will be in that mix again. And the Warriors, I think, will go further. They would have some young guys. Curry's not going to always be Curry. Klay has kind of seen flashes of old Klay. And it looks like, you don't want to say he's regressing. Obviously, they said his injury is going to take 2 years. This is year three. Well, this will be year three. And, you know, he's still coming back. But the problem is the Klay was a big, not just offensive guy, but a defensive guy. And when he had that injury, it kind of slowed on defensively. So now when you have the Warriors getting cooked, they already don't have a lot of another defender. Curry's smaller. Poole is skinnier. Draymond is slower. They don't have much rim protection based on the guys they play. So they needed Klay to be the defender he was before he got injured, and I don't think he'll ever be able to do that because of the injury and because he's older. I mean, at the end of the day, his you know, miles on his body is increasing. So I think the Warriors made a huge mistake. The Spurs are going to look interesting with that Wambabadoobop guy, whatever. The problem with that is the Spurs are a young team. Popovich is a great organization. Obviously, they want to get him some weight on his body and, you know, get him in the gym. We're going to see. We're going to see if that can take time. That's going to take time. You look at how many years it took for Kevin Garnett to physically get up to par in the league, and even Durant. So you won't get pushed around and you won't get, you know, injured so much because you are kind of on like a frail frame type thing. So it's going to be interesting with how soon the Spurs can get him up to speed. The last person we want to talk about is Zion Williamson. I'm not really into talking about people's personal life, but if you want to Google, go ahead. Zion, I'm sure, will be traded. He wasn't traded part of NBA draft. Sometimes when you have a guy you want to get rid of, you say, well, let me get some draft picks like that. I think a lot of teams are concerned about his long-term, not just health, but commitment. One thing about salacious stories is when people see your personal life, it shows your level of commitment. It shows what you do every day, even if you just did this once a month. Even if Zion was into whatever he's into, once or twice a month, it shows his level of commitment and discipline and sacrifice. It's not where a multi-billion-dollar organization would want it to be. So it's very interesting to see him not be traded during the draft period. And I think now it's probably going to be harder for them to trade him because a lot of pieces are already cemented. You draft a guy specifically for your coach, for your playing style, before the offense or defense you want to play. And now you say, well, I'm going to trade this guy who I already figured that would fit my system for Zion Williamson, who I don't know is healthy, I don't know is in shape, I don't know, most importantly, is committed. And a lot of times, unfortunately, when people leak people's business, it really never works out for the person who leaks it. But also, when it comes to business, it slows down the business of the person who is involved. And for Zion Williamson, I don't think his commitment level is where it needs to be. But also, when you talk about that type of money, a lot of people, it's not about who you're sleeping with, whatever, whatever. It's really about, can you control variables? Can you control the people around you? And they look at it like, if you can't control the person that's around you or people, whoever, then I can't trust you with millions of dollars. I can't trust you being a leader in this organization. You can't even trust the person in your family, the person in your car, the person at your house, the person you're sleeping with. You can't control them. And not control in the sense of like a negative thing, but control like, hey, don't record me. Don't do this. Or we have a commitment. We have a trust. Don't put my business out and I won't put your business out. You know, don't put my text messages out there. Don't put my audio out there. Whatever our situation is or whatever it is. When you deal with someone who goes against that, they look at you as not being, whether it's intelligent, whether not being a good decision maker. And those things take precedence, even if you have talent. So I think no matter where Zion's go, it's going to be a knock on him because it showed in the past, whatever the situation going on in his personal life, that he does not have the discipline and sacrifice. But most importantly, he does not have control over variables. He's around people that will turn against him. And that's not good. If he's a leader of my team, I cannot have these stories. And I'm trying to make $200 million, $100 million. He's gonna make $200 million if he stays in the league. I personally don't think he's gonna be able to be in the league much longer with the injuries, with the physical health, and what these stories are, go on. It doesn't matter. The man is not on the field, on the court. He's not in shape, and most importantly, he hasn't expanded his game so he can stay on the floor. He has to get a jump shot quicker. He has to be able to get a mid-range move. He has to be able to shoot from three, so he doesn't have to bulldoze his way to the basket. And I don't think those things are there, and I definitely don't think he'll be able to do that in an off season or a season playing in New Orleans. And obviously, his personal friend leaked that him and the team are not seeing eye to eye, and his teammates are not seeing eye to eye. Again, that's more the discipline and sacrifice, and that if you can control people telling your business, it should be no reason anybody knows what's going on with your teammate that will leak it. Obviously, we all talk to certain friends, and you know, we're honest about what's going on in our job or whatever, but you should not have that business publicized and your teammates look at you like, yo, at the end of the day, we're teammates. We have to work this out. So I don't think the Zion Williamson story will end well. I think they will try to trade him. It doesn't matter where he's going to go. He may not play. He may not be in shape. And most importantly, he may not be able to expand his game quick enough to be able to stay on the court and not be injured. He's going to still have that bulldoze mentality. And that's when the ankle injuries come, the back injuries come, the knee injuries, the hips. When you go on full throttle and another man is same size as you, even smaller than you, when I can shoot him mid-range and just shoot a whole bunch of jumpers, shoot a whole bunch of hook shots, shoot a whole bunch of threes, and not touch anybody. So, we'll see. Anyway, peace.